Well, basically, it is two human beings who might behave in what people believe is abnormal ways. But basically, they're two humans who are worlds apart, but have needs, and those needs meet, and they react with each other and form a beautiful bond. And I hope that people will realize that being a cross-dresser is something which is not a joke, which is not something that should be laughed at. It is a terrible compulsion that has ruined so many lives. I mean, he adored his wife, and she found out, and she hated him. And yet he loved her to the day he died. And if she could have only accepted that he dressed as a woman, but it didn't affect him as loving her. And I did a film years ago called Victim, which helped to change the law on homosexuality. And I just hope that people might see this film and see that they are really two human beings. You should never put labels on people. Labels are terribly dangerous. And one day, people will look at this and say, they were human beings. Not that he was a cross-dresser, not that she was, you know, queer or anything like that. They were just human beings whose behavior was not the majority. That doesn't mean to say they're wrong. That is, you try to make it beautiful.
It's a film very much about an unlikely but beautiful friendship. Can you talk about that experience for you?
Yeah, absolutely. It was a... You can't be somebody else. So what you've got in this film, you've got Derren as a drag queen. You've got Derren as a cross-dresser. You've got Derren who likes this young man, Jordan, who wants to take him under his wing, who wants to, you know, look after him, whereas, in fact, Jordan looks after him, which is the beautiful thing of it, you know? That whereas you think that he's looking after Jordan, Jordan is actually looking after him, and that's what's so beautiful.
This film has been described as your swan song, but your final performance on screen. When you look back both at this film and at the entirety of your career, I'm curious what you feel most proud of at this point as an actor and a storyteller.
Well, I think Victim and I think Where Eagles Dare. But I mean, I've had so many offers to do more films that I suppose I will have to do it. I mean, I've been running a very big company called New Era, which is one of the leading drama exam boards. So I haven't really been inactive, but I love the screen. I love trying to be real. It's very difficult to present reality. And so maybe I'll do some more.
Final question. You mentioned Where Eagles Dare there, so often voted one of the greatest war films ever made. I'm curious, when you look back at that film now with some distance, what your overriding memory is. I mean, obviously, there's a lot of discussion about your accident on set, but obviously, it remains one of the finest performances we've ever seen on screen.
Richard Burton drinking four bottles of vodka a day. Basically. But then Brian Hutton, a great director, as Jamie Patterson is a great director. But one knew it was a good movie, and Clint Eastwood. There's only two of us still alive. Yeah, Clint Eastwood and me, which is a bit sad. But the main memory was Burton drinking, really.